All right, so we are going to the gym. Day one, I am doing measurements because I'm gonna take you guys through transforming this body. I told you guys that I fell off the wagon. So I'm gonna show you how I get back in shape. And I'm gonna invite you to join me. Like before 2025, we're gonna get this body back in shape. Not just for body goals, but also because, I mean, health and fitness is important. So that's what we're about to do. I am currently trying to open the shaker bottle to make my electrolyte drink, which is just gonna help me with hydration. There. Huh? Can you please open this one? This is why you have a husband. I think you're out of frame.
Out of frame.
Okay, so this gym we're going to was the gym we used to go to religiously when we used to stay in Forwards. So it's kind of like a throwback. It's one of my most favorite gyms. I think it's my favorite gym in South Africa, actually. Just the setup, the vibe. No one bothers you, no one stares, everybody's in their own world. So because today is what I would like to call my official day one of getting back to consistent training, I have been training on and off, trying to get back into some sort of routine for the past, I'd say, 2 weeks. But I really want to be intentional now, as I feel like I am in the right mind space to get back into consistent training towards a specific goal. So today we're going to do a weigh-in and we're going to take progress pictures because that's how I love to track my journey. Even though weight is not a specific measurement that I always focus on, I do just like to have it as like a weigh-in and then a weigh-out at the end of my program. So that's what we're going to do. I'm also going to be taking measurements because my goal is to reshape, or the scientific phrase is body recompositioning. Okay, so what that basically means is that I want to decrease my body fat but increase my muscle mass. Okay, and that's what we're going to do in the next few weeks. That's what we're going to do in the next few weeks, and I'm going to take you guys on the journey with me. I think I love the current size I'm at and the current weight I am at. I think I'm around 62, 63. We'll confirm when I get to the scale at the gym in a bit. But I mean, I know that I'm jiggly and I don't want to be jiggly. And my cellulite, girl, let's not even go there. Okay, so I just want to make sure that I reduce the body fat so that I can look a bit more toned, a bit leaner. And besides the look of things in terms of body goals and appearance, I know I feel better when I'm leaner. And overall, it's science that you're healthier when your body fat is not high. So we're gonna be Operation Reshape, okay? Operation Reshape. So let's go to the gym. Enough talking. Right, moment of truth. I've already lost 1 kg. All right, we are here and a bit low in energy, but we're gonna get this workout in. Today is day one of my RESHAPE program and we are focusing on legs, specifically quads and maybe a bit of abs. So it's going to be a simple workout, but it's going to work. It's going to get my heart rate up. It's going to work muscle. And yeah, let me take you through it. In other news, how hot? Right, let's do this. So, we should start with a warm up. Legs spread nice and wide apart. I can go down to touch my toes and then down into a squat. Opening up the hips because I do suffer from tight hips. The warm-up is very important for me, especially on leg day, and because my legs get so stiff, I'm very bad at stretching. So I'm trying to get a bit better with that.
show you guys that view as I do this. So straight back, grounded. As you go down into that squat, opening up the hips, moving side to side. Lift up, stretching the hamstrings, tighten the tummy, down. And we're gonna keep it dynamic. We're not holding it in one position for too long. I feel my hips a bit tight, so I'm just gonna do soft knees, circular motion. One away for five, and then other way for five as well. Going down to lunge as if you're gonna propose, but not. What you're gonna do is push forward, right? Push your pelvis forward. I like to put my hand down on the ground. Get a nice twist in the back over here, right? Sometimes go nice and low to get a real stretch over here. And the hips and the abductors and the groin, and then I move all the way back to stretch my hamstring. So that's the movement. We go forward, twist, down, and back. Forward, twist, down, and back. Forward, twist, down, and back. All right, other side. This one is a bit tighter for me. Knees apart, and again, circle. It's a big one for me. Can you hear my hip clicking? Goodness. It's fascinating. Knee pulls. Just rotating on those ankles. Because your girl, you know, work her ankle. So about eight rotating her rotational side. Gonna start off with squats. Alright, so usually I would say feet below your hips in these squats, but I like to be a bit wider just because of the range of motion of my ankle. Right, if you want to, just go deep as you can and up. We're gonna start with slow and controlled. Tighten the core, keep the chest up, and I'm gonna do 10. 4, 5. As I come up, I'm squeezing the quads, squeezing the booty. 7, 8, 9, and 10.
Attention right. To all lines, then. Attention to all lines, then.
Next movement I'm going to do is to get the heart rate pumping a little bit. We're going to add a jump. Okay? So you're going to watch me changing the way I hold the kettlebell. All right? So I'm going to lower, up, and then pick up. Cool. Next set, same thing. 10 static squats, and then 12 jump squats. Ready? Throw this dumb away. Oh, goodness me. Why did I let my get? I can't even speak. Why did I let myself get so unfit? Alright, going in the warm up. Great going, Coach Slim. Alright, final set. sip. Now the trick with hydration breaks is that you want to take small sips, not big gulps. Catch your breath. If you're struggling to catch your breath like me, hands above your head. Deep breath in through the nose, out through the mouth. All right. Next move. We're doing lunges. Okay. So, first set I'm going to do without weights. Right. So we're right here with my lunge. I don't like taking too much of a big step, right? Number one, I'm short. Number two, I just don't feel like it works my quad enough. Okay, so right there, also in the lunge, make sure that there's space. Okay, so you don't want that back leg right behind when you're going down in your lunge. You want to make sure that there's space between your legs. So as I mentioned, first set, I'm doing without. Cool. When you go down in that lunge, make sure over here you have that balance. Tighten the core down. Push on that leg up. Squeeze the quad. Okay. And because we're working quads, not glutes, we're keeping our chest up, back straight. If I wanted to work glutes, I would lean a bit more forward. See that? But that targets glutes. So let's do quad. 3, 2, 1. I'm doing 12 because there's no weight. 1, 2, squeeze. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It's burning. 10. 11 and 12. Switch. Ready. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. And 12. All right. Gonna add weights. Gonna do a rep of 10, adding weight, and then my last set will be 8, adding weight. So let me give these people a break because it looks like they want to train here and they're intimidated by you guys. So let me do that and I'll show you the next movement when I'm back. Okay, next exercise, we're doing the step ups, one leg at a time. This one sucks. Alright, I'm going to do the first set without weights and then add weights for the second and the third set. Starting with the highest rep count. So 12 step ups without reps. I mean without weights. Per leg. And then add weights on 10, add weights on 8. Alright, so what you want to do, transfer all the weight to the leg that's on the step. Make sure that your knee doesn't pass your toe as you do the step up, and then slow down. Step up, slow down. Up, slow down. You want to tighten your tummy and control as you go down. You can see me shaking because that's because I'm not dropping all the way down. I'm controlling. 1, 5, 6, halfway. Ooh. 7. I'm also trying to stabilize my knee so that it's not wobbling too much. 8. 9. Even as you come up, squeeze the quad before you're going down. 2 more on this leg. I can already feel it putting pressure in my ankle. And 12. Alright. That's the leg. With the ankle surgery, you can feel the tension in my shin on this leg because of the lack of range of motion in this ankle, but we keep pushing. We just got 12 on the next leg. 1, slow down. 2, 3, 4, So I exhale, going up, inhale, and then exhale, going down again. I lost count. I think I'm 5, 6, 7. So many factors when you're training. Tighten the tummy, squeeze the muscle, breathe. 10, count. 11, and 12. When you do that right, it actually kills. Squeezing, let you contract that muscle. Slow release. Next, tighten the tummy. I need to add a weight. I haven't done leg press in a while. So I'm starting very light with 5 kgs on each side. All right. Now the trick with leg press is you want to make sure that your back is not rounded. Okay, so I always like to lift myself a bit higher. It's this one. And then place my legs hip width apart, slightly wider for comfort for me. And then as I lower down my legs. Okay. I also like, you're welcome. I also like to put my hands behind my head. I don't know if this is right, but I kind of feel like it helps with the arch in my back over here so that I'm not rounding my back. That's a trick. Okay. Then as I lower down, ooh, I'm shaking. I want to make sure that my legs come in at 90 degrees and that my knees don't spread too wide apart. Okay. So that's what I'm trying to do. Also, as I lower down, all the weight is in my heels, so I can sort of like lift my toes. And then as I push, squeeze my quads, but not locking my knees, because that's locked, okay? So a slight bend, even though it's straightened. So slowly down to bend, push up, squeeze. Slowly down to bend, push up, squeeze. This is very light for me, so I'm going to use it as a warm-up set in the leg press. And I'm going to do 15 because it's very light, okay? And then I'll add weights. Do 12, add more weights, do 10, and the last rep, the last set will be 8 reps with the heaviest weights I can go right now. So let's start 15. 1, 2, still controlled even though I'm picking up the pace. 3, 4, inhale, exhale as you press. Inhale, exhale. 7, 8, 9, 10, 5 more. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Still got it. All right, that was very light. So I'm going to add 10s on each side, which means I'm pushing 15, 15, 30 in total. Now, I will say, always start lighter, do more reps, and then go heavier rather than starting heavier and then you hurt yourself. So, let's go. So we're doing 12 reps here. Ooh, my sweat towel. Yuck. Just felt like a sticky. I need to wipe that down. Okay, so foot placement first. Hips width apart. Straighten up the back. All right, get comfortable. Before releasing the lever, whatever. English is not my first language. All right, now slowly down and push. 1, 2, 3. Sometimes I hold my hands here for placement because my knees tend to go wider. 9, 10. 2 more. 11. 12. Okay. Now, only problem. Not be walking right in front of my camera, but no problem. My toes are hurting. So, converse. You know, love hate relationship with these bad boys. So let me take my shoes off for the next round. I think I wanna do another round on this weight and do another 12. But if you're following along, you can either keep this weight and go down to 10, right? Because I was doing 12 reps. Or you can add weight and do 10 reps, right? Because we were doing 12. But your body, your choice. And 12. Ooh, okay. Let's go heavier. I'm gonna see how this goes because I might slip if I go heavier, but I'm gonna just try adding 5 on each side, which takes me up to 40 kgs. 40 kgs, 20 per side, no shoes. So let's hope I don't slip. Okay. Now the reason why the warm-up was so important was because I already feel my hips are tight. So by the time I get to this part of the workout, I'm like, yo, if I didn't stretch, I would have injured myself. I know for sure. Okay, so the posture right, leg placement, foot placement rather, hands, and lift. Let's go. We're on 10. I'm going to add for the final round, I'm gonna add 5s. 5s. Oh, I'm gonna take this 5 off and add 10s because of the math. Yeah. Okay. Guys. He has been ruining my entire workout because I need to film him and film myself. So, ad break. Okay.
You can start like, maybe you can do that now.
What are you doing?
Calf raises.
Can I see how you're doing it? The light sucks. I think I should do it from here. Okay. All right. From the side. Let's see. Yeah. Okay. Super lucky. Here's my kiss.
Thank you.
Alright, let's get back. Okay, so I have 25 kgs per side, which means I'm on 50 kgs right now. I weigh 62, as you guys saw. So I'm still not pressing my body weight, which is a nice goal to have, to be able to press your body weight. Right? Because that means your body can actually, or your legs can actually carry your body. But because I'm still with this ankle, you know, I'm trying to take it easy, not trying to re-injure myself. And then I'm out for like another 5 months. So listen to your body, as I mentioned, your body, your choice. Let's get back into my final set, 50 kgs on 8 reps. I smell waffles. How dare they? Focus. Right foot placement. And final eight, mind to muscle connection. Let's go. One. Two. King, five, six, seven, last one, eight. Oh, all right. Okay, so recap. We started off with the static squats, supersetted with jump squats with the kettlebell. Then we went into lunges, then we did step ups. Now we're doing leg press. I would like to do the leg extension, but I don't like filming inside. It's fine because four exercises are more than enough, and I do kind of feel like for week one, that's okay, right? That's enough because we did some good weights. I am now going to end off with calves and abs. I'm literally gonna down and up. I'm not using weights because, first of all, I hate training calves. Second of all, I see no point in it. I know I should, but in my mind, I'm like, I don't have those genetics. I got the side of my family genetics that don't grow calves. Anyway, let's just do this thing. Okay, so nice and slow. Release and up, hold. Release and up. Nice stretch all the way up, tightening the core as well. Four, five. And ten. Hate, 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 hate. Like, I feel like I'm sweating more doing calves than I was sweating in leg press. Like, I'm the only one who hates training calves. Like, why, God? Okay, round two. Round two, I'm gonna add 5 kgs. Let's do that. But that's the most I'm doing, you guys. Don't at me. Okay, starting on the other leg. Let's go. One. Two. I should be doing this with shoes. Three. Another leg. Yo. My quads are giving in. You know, like, I feel like one of those baby giraffes trying to learn to walk. That's how I feel like. All right. Let's go. Eight. Ooh. I mean, have you seen white girl legs? Like Afrikaans white girl legs. Damn. Whew. Love y'all. Like, you guys are my real models. Okay. Okay, okay, okay. I'm gonna take it up to 10 kgs. And this is me being very ambitious. I am gonna do six. Six on 10 kgs. Only because I'm trying to build my calves. And here's the thing with calves, you guys. They are endurance muscles, like, because you walk for miles, right? So they can actually take a lot. And the only way you build your calves is not really endurance, it's by adding weights. So 10 kgs. Let's go. Ay, ay, ay. You! Okay, we did it. I don't have white girl legs. By the time I'm done with this program, that means I need to go into prayer and fasting for them. It clearly works. Don't work. Alright, let's go do abs and finish up, y'all. Okay, so in my fitness classes, I used to love doing these crunches because they just work. Okay, so crunches halfway to your setup. Setup is literally all the way up, which we are not doing. We are doing a crunch, which is halfway. So in order for you to get your halfway mark for your body, we're gonna extend our arms, okay? We're gonna come up, lifting our chest, chin, okay? We're gonna keep to the ceiling, okay? So you can breathe nicely. And as you lift up, you're gonna exhale. As soon as your hands, palms of your hands, touch your knees, back down, okay? So we're literally doing 15 of those. Ready? Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Yes, thank you. Okay, so we're doing 15, 12, 10. Yeah, 15, 12, and 10. All right, so now the trick with these crunches, can you see what my stomach looks like? Okay, that's relaxed. When I do these crunches, I am engaging my core, so tightening the core. So think of it as you are exhaling, or you are trying to clean the mirror of your core. So you're kind of doing like, right? So as you go, tighten the tummy, hold it there for the next set. Did I ever tell you guys how you need to thank your trainers? Because working out, breathing, and counting, extreme sport. All right, next one we're doing boat to low boat. So you're gonna start with your legs extended, okay? You're lifting them so they're not touching the ground. Hands behind you for some support. Exhale, inhale. Okay, 12, 10, 8. Ready? Starting with 12. Breathe. I have a love-hate relationship with this one, but trust me, girl, it works. Okay, so hands above your head, one leg bent. Okay, what we're doing is we're coming up. 2, 3. That's what we're doing. This is a finisher. 10 per leg, no breaks in between, which means we're doing 20 straight, just alternating legs. Okay, first leg 10, second leg 10. Ready? I want a nice long stretch, and when you come up, obviously tighten the tummy. Exhale as you come up. 3, 2, 1, let's go. 1, 2. Ten. Woo. Oh my goodness. Lower abs on fire. All right, we're gonna flip it over. Let's go into a stretch. Stretching is important. This is what I tell myself all the time, and then I neglect to do it. So we're gonna do it together. On your tummy, hands below your shoulders, trying not to squish the mic. Lifting the chest, okay? Pushing your hips into the mat, opening up the chest. Nice deep breath in through the nose, out through the mouth. All right, what you can do is just side to side, just loosen up that lower back a bit. I feel mine is a bit tight, especially because of my tight hips. So everything affects everything. Take your time here. One more deep breath in through the nose, out through the mouth. And let's go into child's pose. So toes together, knees apart, bum onto your heels, and then you're literally just gonna stretch forward into that child's pose, and we're gonna hold it there. While you're here, just take some time to thank God for getting your body through this incredible workout. You moved your body. Movement is an expression of praise. I always say movement is an expression of praise. So let's sit up, let's stretch out those legs. One leg to the side, other leg bent. You're gonna stretch and tuck your toes if you can. If you can't reach for your ankles, that's fine. Okay, be flexible. Head onto your knee. Hold it there. Four, five. Go a little deeper. 4, 3, 2. And switch. And 1. Very nice. Feet together. Knees apart. I'm gonna stretch to push your knees down, okay? Hold it there. 4, 5, 4. Can you see the difference between static stretches and dynamic? These ones we're holding in position as a cool down. hold it there for 2 more seconds. Last one. Okay. Legs in front of you. We're going to stretch forward and hold it there.
Very nice. Thanks for working out with me. I absolutely died. Next week, I will add the leg extension if I'm feeling strong enough. Remember, your body, your choice. But this is the Reshape program. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys later. Okay, so just a quick transformation video. I hope this is clear. Okay, front view, relaxed, side view, relaxed, back view. Okay, so as you can see, I am out of shape, lots of body fat. I really like my weight, I really like my size, but I just don't like my composition of it. So that's what we're working on, and I'm gonna take you guys with me on this journey. So thank you so much for watching this vlog, and I will see you in the next one. Bye for now.